I started to love mathematics at school. I got a scholarship to Oxford and I was given a project involving permutation groups. And I have essentially worked in that area, but in a broad sense, all my life. Experimental designs I used in clinical trials and in agricultural trials to compare different crop varieties. The variance might be down to rainfall, the number of sunny days, or the aspect of the field. And we want to have the design in such a way you can say this difference is due to the difference in the varieties and choose the most suitable variety of crop. My contribution was to introduce a new way of guaranteeing the validity of the analysis. We realised that the symmetry of the designs was important and we used representation theory and group theory to justify the analyses of well-known types of experimental designs, but also develop new families of designs which might be used in the future. I think that a problem with mathematics is its invisibility. Everything that we use in this modern age, the programs in our mobile phones or the internet or the computers, the networks that I study, the rather symmetrical ones, are the ones which would be preferred to use, say, in searches on the World Wide Web. So these very large networks, sometimes they're in trees, tree structure, they're preferred because they're so efficient. So there was a computer scientist, Jan Hoskins, and she was talking about the mathematics of twills. What makes a fabric a twill is that there's a certain design of over and under of the threads, and so you try to get the same, on average, number of unders and overs, otherwise the fabric curls up at the edges. Jan wanted to enumerate all the different twills, and she didn't know whether they'd got the programs right or not. So we used group theory to give a precise count, and then the computer scientists could use this guaranteed number to work out whether they'd enumerated all of them or not. I've also developed algorithms, and they've been incorporated into group theory computer systems, Magma and GAP, which are used by mathematicians, are used by scientists, engineers, whenever they need to investigate the symmetries of the structures that they're studying. My major message to the general public would be that mathematics is really important. Mathematicians these days are working alongside other scientists, other engineers, and where that mathematics is going in the future will be different from anything that we know.